river rafting.
The nice thing about geologic maps is that the geologists will often draw a line across the map, and then he'll show you what the layers, what he thinks the layers look like underneath. Yeah. So you can see these lines, like here's a B right here, and all the way up there is a B primed. And you can come down here to the map, and here's the B, and all the way over there is the B primed. And notice that this particular line crosses the structure that is called the East Kaibab monocline, and that's the fault and fold partly associated with the Carbon Canyon area. And so right here is where the East Kaibab monocline goes through, and you see how the rocks are nice and flat right here, and then all of a sudden there's a bend.
Yes.
And there's a lower elevation over here than back over here.
And so what happened, what we think happened, is there's the rock down here in the basement is really hard, and it broke and faulted, and that's the fault right there. But the rocks on top were relatively soft. Mm-hmm. And so as the hard rock pushed the softer rock up above, instead of breaking, these rocks up here bent and folded.
Mm. It's like having a layer of wet sand, and underneath you've got a wooden block, and you push the wooden block up, and the sand will drape over the...
Right. That occurred somewhere then close to the flood time.
Yeah, well, the Tapeat sandstone was deposited early in the flood. And at the end of the flood, when earth movements took place to re-equilibrate, that the folding occurred then. And the sediments were still damp and soft, and therefore they could bend quite easily. And then they dried out, and we had the cementation of the grains afterwards. And then we motored down here, and all the way past Phantom Ranch, all the way around here, come around to this is the monument fold. This is still Tapeat sandstone. It's actually marked on the map that there's a fold there, but there's also a fault line.
There's a fault underneath, and the rock underneath pushed up and made the rocks on top fold because they were soft. We're going to be looking at this big fold or this big bend in the rock. You can see the granite and pushed up right here, and making the big fold in the Tapeat. And it looks like the Tapeat is bent plastically right over top of this fault. It doesn't look like the fault has extended up into the Tapeat sandstone at all.
And I think the easiest way to sample it is to come over and go up that slope to get to it there, and then come over and get to it on the other side of that slope.
Maybe that thin bed might be the better one to get because we're in the finer grain
material. Oh, yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
I agree.
Well, why don't you and I go up with the ladder?
Okay.
Let Andrew stay down here. We'll tape everything that we can do.
The plan is to sample two beds. Okay, the fold comes like this and does this. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's the overall profile. So because of the scree slope, we're going to sample in here. And we're going to sample in here.
Well, it's just an interesting area that we want to try to sample. So we're going to take a sample right where this bed is kind of smeared.
And this has shifted this way, but it did so without cracking the rock.
So the rocks pose some questions to us. The folds pose some questions to us. And not just to a creation scientist, but to a conventional scientist as well. But then we want to go in there and study the rocks and look at that fold and look at the rocks under the microscope and see which paradigm fits the best.
And so the argument is not about that physical evidence, it's how you interpret that physical evidence. And to interpret it, you've got to have a framework. And our view of history is the Genesis is history. The Bible is an eyewitness account given to us by the Creator who was there. And it gives us a time frame, it gives us the description of what happened during the flood. And so we can take that description and look at the geological implications, for example, and then go out and test those implications.
Good, perfect. Okay.
Seven down, one to go.